Hello, beautiful Capricorns. How are you today? Welcome to the channel. My name is Donna. This is Irish Donna Tarot, and this is a Taroscope, your life path and abundance reading for the month of October. You are here twice in your reading. You are the Capricorn Queen of Pentacles, and you are the Devil card. So let's jump in. This is a very interesting reading because it captures a time in your life for which you are savoring everything that's good, but what you want is shifting. Many of you right now are very much feeling empathetic. It's like you're feeling the weight of the world and all the emotions and everything that's going on. You feel it in a very personal way right now. It could be a little bit overwhelming for you. We have this energy of the Lady of the Mirror. And it is reflective non-judgment. You are assessing your life. You are taking time to really define what makes you happy. Sky dancers surrender. You want to surrender to having a more balanced life, to having one that has more joy and happiness day to day. And you are making dramatic changes at this time, Capricorn. You have done it beautifully. You are leaving behind this feeling that life is really tough, life is hard, life is unexpected, all of which it is, right? But you're taking this time to really go back to your hopes and dreams for childhood. The fairy of youth is calling your name and calling on you to think about your dreams, you know, what it is that you'd like to manifest and what you want your life to be to manifest as in the future. And it's very evident here. It's very beautiful. We get the energy that you have absolute courage, wisdom, tenacity to do whatever you want to do. And one of your goals this month is to really return to simpler life, to return to a time when you just felt you could get up in the morning and you could automatically smile. It could be hearing a puppy bark. It could be seeing a child scramble around in their pajamas, chasing a ball. But you're in this very, very sweet mode that though you're very strong, you want to get up and have that sort of immediate moment in the day of appreciating tenderness and joy and the people you love. When we look at partnership for you at this time, we see that for those of you who are single, you're very, very good at determining what you want career-wise. You know how to take care of yourself. And the King of Swords says that you're very much, King of Swords twice here, you're very much making life decisions right now with a partner, if you have one, and by yourself, if you don't. You want more value out of your day, that as you go forward, you're willing. You love to work hard. You like to be enthusiastic. We have a partner here helping search for answers with you if that is your choice. And if not, we see you're in this mode of looking at your investments. You know, many of you would like to retire earlier, and I'm getting the abundance is likely to be there for you if you'd like to do that. But we see that in business, in when it comes to other people's money, your investments, you're really studying this very closely. Now we have Virgo here twice with the Hermit and the Hermit. You're really looking at exactly how you could possibly use some of your investment money to make your life easier now, to do a lot less direct work and to do work that is much more strategic. So that's what I see in terms of your abundance of money. You have clarity. You have the smarts. You have the willpower to have a simpler life. And that is where you're going in your money as well as the money of a partner. So, you know, for those of you in partnership, you're very much on a powerful change as a couple. And for those of you who aren't, you're doing it by yourself. We look at your third house of your neighborhood. Look at the Strength card twice. So many duplications. But we see that you have fire in your belly to maybe even do some community work, some community service. But this really speaks to the fact that you love where you're at. You feel as though you'd like to be somewhere with starry nights, a beautiful skyline, a beautiful view of the world. And you are very much in your feels about how you're going to accomplish that. You're not quite sure. We get, again, you're studying business options here with a partner, with or by yourself, but we see that right now, in terms of higher education, in terms of long distances away, we see this Hermit card looking off into the future or looking backwards. So it's almost like you're deliberating whether you're going to do things a new way or maybe tried and true ways of earning money. And I think it's going to be a combination of both. But, you know, we see you in this energy of just taking time out for yourself, which is always a good idea. You're studying something very closely and you're making sure that you don't make a decision until you feel fully settled in that decision. So it is Mercury retrograde. It's a good time not to make the full-blown decision right now. We have the energy in your fourth house of home and hearth that where you're at fulfills an awfully lot of energetic happiness for you. The Eight of Wands is moving forward very swiftly, really liking where you live. But the Four of Swords says that there may be sort of a loneliness attached to it. And I'm going to say right off the bat, I felt that with these cards, some of you or many of you have children who are leaving home either to go off to college or they're leaving home from after college. I do feel as though that is not for everybody, clearly, but I do feel that you're going through this period of nostalgia in which home, you know, you come home and it's maybe an empty house, empty nest sort of feeling here, Four of Swords, because you're very happy to be there, and yet there's a little bit of a pain associated with it. We also get that, you know, in your career, you're just feeling like you need something new. You've had it. I see you having new activity here in business. The Ace of Swords, the Ace of Wands, absolutely spurring new ideas into a victorious phase. And you have all the capability with the Queen of Business and the Queen of Business, Queen of Finance, Queen of Business, promotion and the strength. So for those of you who are looking to make a major shift in career, I think that you're on the precipice of doing that. When we look at your house of romance and your house of hopes and dreams and friends, we see that your house of romance is leaving you a bit unfulfilled. You feel as though work life has you by the tail feathers and there's just not enough time or energy to go out and have fun. And we see that you are going to start associating yourself with possibly a new group of friends, but it looks like a group of you have fire in your belly to go travel, to go do something that is energetic and full of just passion and fun, a lot of laughter, a lot of joy. You know, it's also for those of you who are in big group affiliations where there's been a lot of responsibility, you're going to kick back and you're going to take a back seat to others and you're going to find yourself out there having more fun. When we look at your sixth house of your health, of your everyday life, you know, what is Monday like for you from Monday to Sunday? We see great happiness and joy. Look at this, the Ten of Cups, happily ever after. You know, your day-to-day life looks like it's very successful, Capricorn. It looks as though many of you are in a family of some sort that is doing quite well and you're very happy in that energy. You know, it's very Piscean, very dreamy energy. When we look at what's going on behind the scenes for you in your 12th house, you know, you're saving your money and you're working on some sort of new craft, new trade, a creative project. You're learning something that you're going to turn into cash. Again, some of you could be studying something like, you know, how to have an Airbnb or how to retire early, but there is total transition and a time, returning to a time when life isn't so hard, when you really can just live in your feelings more and to take a deep breath and to get up every day joyful for the day. Capricorn, welcome to your love reading. The overall energy for your love reading is a Queen of Swords making a head over heart decision. Making a decision based on facts. That's really very reflective of your life path reading because it's about change. There is a sudden epiphany that you are having and you are letting go of a burden, Capricorn. Whatever has happened here in terms of a fight or a situation or something very unexpected in a relationship in the recent past, you basically have just said, you know what? I'm not going to keep doing it that way. I'm going to give up those burdens. I'm going to let it go. We see the Judgment card, another card of you letting something go. Now, it doesn't have to be your person, but it can be letting go of burdens associated. Sometimes when we are in relationship, we say, well, I'm going to be an extra good supportive spouse, or I'm going to be extra good supportive roommate, and I'm going to go do all their laundry. And you realize you don't have to. Like, it just isn't actually to the benefit of the relationship. So whatever it is in relationship, you and your partner are giving up some sort of burdens. That can be a fight. It can absolutely be a total breakup. And with the Judgment card, I feel that for many of you, you are dealing with this in the aftermath. I feel as though for those who are coming to the reading, I'm not really predicting a future breakup. I'm only predicting that you're going to make great changes, you know, in your relationship so that you leave the things behind that make you unhappy. You can do that within the parameters of a relationship if two people agree on it. But I think for many of you, you've already left something behind and that you're really going to choose to have a partner who has the same values as you. And we get that beautiful judgment here. Now, for some of you, this is actually a divorce, right? Judgment of divorce. So take it as it resonates. You know, this is a general reading. It'll be different for everybody. But it also could be that you have a partner that's doing something similar. So, you know, when I mean, it would be like if you're separated and now your partner who you're dating as a separated person may also make those similar life choices. We get the feeling that, you know, you're making a decision at this point in time to walk away. This is, to me, a very definitive way of just looking at dramatic change in your love life. When we look at the card that says how your person feels about you, you know, they're at the same crossroads you are, how they see this situation going forward. But we get the Eight of Cups and the Eight of Cups and the Ten of Swords. So for many of you, you feel betrayed by someone around you. The good news is though that you have supportive friends who are helping. And we also see that there's a lot of energy here that speaks to the fact that you're relieved by this. You're dropping those burdens. This is most likely, you know, the strength of your energy as this King of Pentacles. For you, you know, I see that you are looking forward into the future and you want to have more happiness and joy. Capricorn, there you are in your reading. You felt very restricted, you know, in some sort of situation. For many of you, this will not be romance. It will be a significant relationship or a job or something of that sort. So, you know, it doesn't always read the way we expect it to when we pull out love cards. But we see this Capricorn energy that you are really set. You are very much drawn to somebody who has taught you a lot about having fun, living life at a larger level. Spirit is recommending right now that you choose happiness, you choose love, you have Venus. And so what we see here is a brand new relationship coming in for you. Now, I don't think it's anything to do with what's happened here. The Ace of Cups is new relationship, and we have the Queen of Cups. So that's very Cancerian energy, very much being in your feels. So Capricorn, I feel like for many of you, this breakup could have taken a long time to happen. and that this is nothing that you would be new for those for whom it resonates. If it's not your story, it's not your story. But we definitely see you coming into a beautiful time in your life where you're making choices that are very reflective of your happiness, of the deeper inner self, you know, of being more lighthearted, laughing, having more beauty in your life. And it looks like whoever you dealt with at one point may have been very controlling, and they may have really been someone who didn't know how to partner, is how I'm seeing this. So, you know, when people don't know how to partner, they don't know how to live in union with someone, it's better to just let them be and to have this beautiful love relationship in this energy of the Ace of Cups with the Queen of Cups. Very much Capricorn. Very touchy-feely, you know, Cancerian energy is your seventh house. So home and hearth are very important to you. Let's go ahead here and see more about the new love part of this reading. Let's see what we have. I'm going to do a you versus them, and I'm going to do it for the new person. Okay, let's see. Stay positive here. I feel as though this is something that most of you, for whom it resonates, this is not going to be at all a surprise. And if it doesn't resonate, it's just not your part of the reading. But new love can be your part of the reading. Look at that, the Ace of Coins, the two best aces for a new relationship, one that can go the distance. So we also have, oh, the Star card. We saw that in your life path reading. The star was there and you were going towards that star. So we have your person really loving you. Look at that Queen of Cups clarifying, the Ace of Coins. The Ace of Coins is an offer. It oftentimes represents the engagement ring when it comes time to put the Three of Cups with it. Let's see what we have here. Your person, let's see. So you are coming in with this energy, Eight of Coins. Remember, we saw that also in the Life Path reading, the Queen of Pentacles making another visit. Capricorn, there you are. You're all about nurturing the connection, the sweetness, and the Magician card. Oh, Capricorn, new love for you. It looks absolutely exquisite. I have goose pimples. I'm so happy for you. I'm going to leave it there. Send me a love from Chicago. Send some back. Tell me where you're from. Leave a comment. I answer all of them. Thank you for joining me.